Hello. This video lays the basis for a revolution in economics. Indeed, it overthrows existing economics by outlining a new way of understanding reality. The new way then opens up a fresh vista in which there are new animals and new plants, that's to say, new policy options for the solution to the world's economic and environmental problems. Impossible, you might say. Impossible. There's nothing new in economics. Mainstream economics is established scientific fact. It is efficient, in balance, and all its outcomes are just, you might say. But in truth, mainstream economics is not efficient, not in balance, and all its outcomes are not just. For example, there are preposterous accumulations of wealth which do not trickle down to ordinary people because it is impossible for the very rich to spend all their money, even if they wanted to, which they do not. The middle classes are being hollowed out. In America, real incomes have been going backwards for 25 years. Now, how is that possible? When at a time, the physical, technological capacity to produce is going up like this all the time. And yet real middle class incomes are going backwards. There is ever increasing debt, private debt, corporate debt, national debt. And that debt is at levels higher than those in 2008. And there is inability to address the great technological shift, which is smashing out traditional jobs and replacing them with temporary, part-time, zero-hours contract, gig economy jobs, which are not really jobs at all. Indeed, mainstream economics has no answer to the inevitable advance of artificial intelligence, which is massively increasing potential output whilst destroying jobs. And please remember that mainstream economics thinks that a woman doing caring 24 hours maybe at a stretch, 7 days a week. Mainstream economics thinks that woman does no work because she's not part of the formal economy. But the woman works hard, and of course, without her work, there would be no human race. Lastly, the financialized global economy is tottering on the cusp of collapse, but it's being propped up by vast amounts of quick fix money, which only prolongs the party a little longer, but creates huge crises to come. Many alternative economists and many conventional economists all say the same. A great change is needed. And so we turn to Thomas Kuhn, who pointed out that a new paradigm is incompatible with the old one. That's to say, it completely replaces it. Yes, we are talking Copernicus and Galileo. The Copernican revolution was an overthrow of science. It led to today's astronomy and rocketry, and it also led to the overthrow of the power of kings and autocrats, without which there would be no democracy today. We're talking Louis Pasteur and Charles Darwin. Alfred Wegener. You know, volcanoes, earthquakes and tsunamis. And Barbara McClintock, jumping genes. Over 20 years ago, Professor Rogers Hollingsworth and colleagues did some quite remarkable research. It cost millions of dollars and is not widely known, and it is my belief that it has probably been suppressed. Because it establishes that over time, even American society will lose its power and lose its influence and come to an end. In other words, the end of history. No, history will continue, and at some point there will be substantial change. The researchers found that three factors contribute to the creation of big new ideas. Firstly, deep, widespread, conservative knowledge of the main subject. For example, the Ptolemaic theory, which said that the Earth is the center of the universe. And therefore, the rulers on Earth have been appointed by God. Secondly, that there then arises tension between progressive thinkers on the edge of the subject and conservative thinkers in the center. Copernicus noticed, for example, that some of the stars, which we call planets, had quick, slow motions, to and fro motions, and light, dark differences. And those things were incompatible with the old Ptolemaic theory. But the mainstream, the conservatives in the center, said, you're wrong. And they invented the theory of epicycles, saying that these planets were really making little cycles like this. It's a completely false theory. But the point is, when faced with the clear evidence of the truth, mainstream theory decided to crush it because the implications of the new paradigm were revolutionary. So we've got two factors. What was the third factor? The researchers found that it's some force or opposition coming from the outside, and it interacts with the forces on the edge of the subject. And the interaction from the force coming from outside and the progressive thinking on the edge creates the new paradigm. Yes, but what was this powerful force coming from the thing from the outside? Well, remember that Copernicus and Galileo were doing something which was not just dangerous, but was going to result in their death. They were putting their lives at risk. And therefore, the force or opposition coming from the outside is really a deep-seated, radical willingness to challenge everything about a society, even though death could be the penalty. So the third factor was this resolute intellectual courage and bravery, acting on the new information about the planets. And from that, from the interaction, you get the creation of the new paradigm. What is the situation today? Well, There's conservative economic thought, and exists widely, and all its underlying assumptions are deeply embodied and interconnected. And as a result, because of the interconnection, there will never be substantial change in future without a paradigm shift. Secondly, there is tension with the progressives on the edge of the subject because, and here it comes, there are 59 false assumptions underlying mainstream economics. And remember that because of the interconnection between assumptions, it only needs one of them to be shown to be false, or maybe two. And the whole structure starts to crack and crumble, and soon it collapses. So what is the first false assumption? It's simply the belief that banks lend existing money, but they do not lend existing money. The lent money is created out of nothing by pressing computer buttons. Nobody's private money, not yours, not mine, not the banks, is being lent. New money is created. The Bank of England says so. The Federal Reserve of America says so. And yes, the greatest economist of all, J.K. Galbraith, he said so. But because he said so, they never awarded him a Nobel Prize. Of course, people are led to believe that the banks lend existing rather than newly created money. And it's then claimed that the money is directed at the purposes of the free market economy, which they claim is efficient. But it's not true. The money is directed at derivatives, the bidding up of existing asset prices, such as shares and housing, consumer credit, debt which cannot be repaid, the speculative trading of currencies. Indeed, the money goes into anything except the spreading of the real economy to every individual in society. And that's the crux of it. Unless productive power is widely spread in society, there can never be a true balance of supply and demand. The second false assumption is that interest is necessary, but it is not necessary. A charge for administration is necessary. Collateral and a business plan are necessary. These things are necessary, but interest is not necessary. Interest diminishes ability to repay. It transfers resources from poor to rich. It puts the world into ever increasing debt. It prevents clean water and green electricity, and it doubles, trebles, or more the cost of any capital project. Starting at £28 million with some price rises, compound interest took the cost of the Humber Bridge to £439 million. That's 15 times the original price. Yet the bridge is a money maker. Every year the fees from travellers more than cover the cost of staff salaries, maintenance and repair. But because of compound interest, the thing is now a horrendous, ever-increasing debt. Please note that the new paradigm will not stop banks lending existing money. It will not stop them lending their own money. It only stops them creating new money. And it does that by a gentle rise to 100% banking reserves. And there's nothing new in that. Most of the great economists have actually proposed that as well. Simmons, Fisher, Milton Friedman, and yes, even the governor of the Bank of England, Mervyn King. Except that they don't also propose the spreading of the real economy to every individual in society. Indeed, what is new in this video is that the spreading of the real economy to every individual in society. Well, it's now time to reveal how the new paradigm is created. Put simply, Islam is the third factor. Islam is powerfully present, highly distinctive. I mean, think of Ramadan and fasting, for example. But its biggest characteristic is its opposition to riba or interest. The opposition to interest then interacts with the insights on the edge of the subject. That is to say that money today is created out of nothing by the banks and that interest is added. The interaction then creates the basis of the new paradigm, which is simply this, that there is no intellectual or physical barrier to the creation by the National Bank of a large supply of interest-free money for the spreading of the real economy to every person in society, as long as the money is repaid and cancelled, leaving behind, of course, in existence, the productive assets. Because the money is interest-free, there is a rapid implementation of productive capacity and a rapid repayment in a way which is completely and totally inconceivable at present. Producers and consumers become the same people. For the first time ever, Say's theorem will actually exist in practice. We will have a cheap way of building houses, of building clean water and sewage systems, of spreading ownership to everybody, that's the key thing, of interest-free loans for students, of ensuring microcredit for small business, of building bridges, railway systems, and major capital projects, of generating electricity in clean, green ways, for example, in tidal lagoons. And we will have a cheap way of building mangrove-crested barrages to stop the erosion of land. All these things and much more are possible. There are many ways that implement the new paradigm, and some of them will be set out in the next video by Talib Wasi. The full subject is dealt with in the book A New Paradigm Response, and you might like to visit a website, binaryeconomics.net. Thank you for watching. Goodbye. Plus de tristesse, et j'aspire à l'instant précis où nous serons. Heureux, je te veux.
today.